typical infrastructure stocks have just been horrendous, and they are a great tell, Carl, for where this bill is. Mansion and Caterpillar.
This is a separate bill from infrastructure, which we're still waiting.
No, but I'm saying nothing. Right. Everything's stalled.
Yeah.
Everything is stalled. It, making it so that I know Costin's right. Is it, but the problem with it is that if there's no urgency, how do we make a judgment that it's going to impact 2021 numbers? I mean, it's hard to.
There's the added layer of, say, you got an infrastructure bill. Where would the raw materials come from? This Goldman note warning about commodity prices and ongoing scarcity. They're talking about oil going back to 80.
Right.
Aluminums. Yep. You know, gas.
By the way, you guys seen uranium? I know that's a little off beat. Well, you see what's going on with uranium?
Actually, no, I'm not that.
It's
close
out
to
of control. It's gone up enormously. Yes, because of potentially recommissioning. Nuclear power is clean
and climate change
and coming around. But yes, uranium has moved up dramatically.
I went to buy a bicycle this weekend. Have you seen this? I went to see a Trex bike. I figured that'd be maybe 600, 700. It was 4,000.
I went to PC Richard to buy a speaker, and we were just chatting with the dude. He's like, you want a new Sub-Zero ice maker? July.
July.
If you're renovating your kitchen and
July.
July.
No, July already happened.
Yeah,
no. I mean, July.
The next one.
July.
Wait for the next one.
And meanwhile, my coffee guy says his costs have gone up 30% also.
Now, we all know it. That's the thing that is so difficult.
He's like,
why is the market down? Well, the market has been going down of late.
A little bit.
I've had a construction. I've had a bathroom that's now since February. Started February. And it's nowhere. It's nowhere near. Glass. Forget it. I mean, you're begging Kohler, private company. There's nothing. I mean, you can't get a job done.
So when is this all going to work its way through?
Into the stock market?
No. When are all these supply chain disruptions going to start to melt away, so to speak? Well, when does this
start to moderate? I think when the ice maker melts away. I think that we're all kind of sitting here thinking, well, if you had bought the speaker, what would it be? If I buy the bike, I try to buy a carbon steel rather than aluminum, but carbon steel's up more than aluminum. I mean, the raw cost of everything, including your coffee guy, which may be the ultimate kind of lipstick indicator.
Yeah.
Now, how his margins must be horrible.
Well, also because foot traffic here in this area is down.
But who can handle it? You know,
so
who handles
it? It's not easy
Starbucks
for a small businessman.
That's why Starbucks 119 going to 125, I think.
The story on Reuters this morning, the headline is, from zippers to glass, shortages of basic goods hobble U.S. economy. But your general view has been, at least on, say, oil, that demand destruction will keep it in check to some degree.
Well, this is where the Saudis have a price. They don't want it to go to 80. The one that we have to talk about, we're going to be talking about all winter, is that natural gas is finally, because we're such an export power and because there's a mismatch with pipelines. David, natural gas is going to end up being the cost for consumers.
You made that point last week on Mad, I know, as well.
I'm not going away on that one. I got a couple of guys talking about how we've exported our way into hell.